sister.
It's testament to motherfucker. I'm kicking it with my brothers. I'm rapping a 5'9". You know, greater fucking color. My gas screaming killer.
What is up, everyone? It's Roos. I hope everyone is doing well. And right in the pre-workout. Delta 10, not Delta 8. Trying Delta 10. Everyone's telling me to try that THCV. Comment down below what you think of THCV. So THCV is apparently even stronger than Delta 9, which is a psychoactive THC. I have to try that shit because I'm Mr. Stay High All the Time. It's where you edit the Stay High All the Time intro. Anyway, so I took... Nickelodeon! This is PG-13 vlog. So when I react to it on my other channel, I'll tell you my very lengthy pre-workout stack. But as far as the PG-13 pre-workout stack, I'm going with one scoop of Gorilla Mind, Gorilla Mode. I'm going with beta-alanine because I've been pretty on point with saturating beta-alanine. And I'm going to go with one scoop of nitric. So this is stim-free pump. So I'm keeping the stimulants, the caffeine low, but I'm still going heavy with the nitrates. And then I'm going to do some shroom pills. I'm going to take some Hawaiian ginger because my fucking stomach is all fucked up. And then RxA to wash it down. Today's training is gonna be like a very, very hard training session, but it's gonna be boring to watch. And everyone's telling Austin, like, here, I want the whole workout, every single set, even me breathing in between. So we're gonna do more of a lengthy edit where I'm gonna train chest, back, and shoulders, and I'm resting tomorrow and I'll do legs Saturday. So every once in a while when I take a massive amount of things before a workout, I need to destroy my body so the skeletal muscle is recruiting, so it's not going to my intestines and organs and shit. So I have to actually kill my body this workout to a point where like tomorrow I won't want to train, I'm so sore. So that's what you guys are about to watch. Tomorrow I will recover with a bunch of food, rest, but yeah, you're gonna see a crazy high volume enhanced bodybuilder workout. I think that's what Austin or Andrew will title this, like super enhanced bodybuilder workout. I don't recommend training like this unless you're stupid enhanced. I've been ramping up my shit. My weight this morning is 241. So me going back on shit, I'm not even eating more because I don't take that much shit. I'm going back up, so I will have to carb cycle. That's why I'm trying to get this training out of here. Get full, get, you know, bubbly as far as my muscles go, and then cut back down because I need to get closer to 230. I did not expect myself to be able to creep back up to 250 so easily, yet here I am, 241 in the morning, while not really eating that much, just going on the amount of drugs I should be on. So it's been little annoying. I just have to keep my carbs super low. As far as the coach is concerned, I feel like you guys are right. I need to talk to him. I haven't talked to him yet. I see a lot of bullying in the comments about who I should pick. I've listened, I've replied, so I'm not gonna say his name just yet because, you know, that's unprofessional if I don't talk to him first privately behind the scenes. But I agree, the one YouTube channel you guys keep linking me, as well as other influencers have shouted him out as well in my circle, I'm definitely gonna give him an interview and see if he wants to deal with my crazy ass. Obviously, I think it'll be really good for his YouTube channel because I know I bitch about my shit being shadow banned, but I feel like he has a lot of useful information. He's much older than me. And I feel like you guys picked the right coach. And last time, you know, I didn't listen to everyone as far as doing the first coaching thing. Because my main goal with Alec was to fucking yank him into the fucking metaverse. Derek has been begging Alec to come into the metaverse for like fucking 2-3 years now. So I had to complete that side quest, Austin. I got to like fucking 90%. I'm like, fucking, you know, that's it. So I'm gonna drink this pre-workout. I took my shroom pills. Me and Austin are gonna head to a different LA because I want one. I want this weird chest machine because I'll be training high volume. And I need the sauna. I need the sauna because I'm definitely, obviously, you can see my fucking face is inflated. So I'm going to rip some water off and Austin's going to film the entire workout. But this is like, again, I really do not want people who are natural or slightly enhanced training like this because it's a waste of time. And this muscle workout, like, think of it as like I'm inflating myself like a balloon animal. It's not really going to equate to like dense strength muscle, right? I'm training to compete. I have to look bubbly on stage and filled out. So I have to train like a bodybuilder. This is not the way I enjoy training. I will go back to power building probably in the summer of next year. I'll probably have to train like a bodybuilder for quite a while to kind of like redo my physique. So that's the update. I'll see you guys at the gym.
All right, guys. So this is the ever long DM box. And I put up a poll where I was asking, oh, and this is the request to get in the DM box, right? I was going to put up a poll where I was like, what do you guys think of No Nut November? And yeah, I got a ton of engagement off that. I'm always interacting on Instagram despite my main Instagram might be fucked. I already have a backup in the works, so I might do the Austin, the little switcheroo where I change my ads. Like, as I grind up the backup, I'll switch the ads. So I might do that. But anyways, basically, I said, what do you think of No Nut November? And yeah, I got a lot of feedback. So No Nut November is about bringing awareness to porn addiction and how porn addiction takes all your vigor through synthetic dopamine and shrinks your penis. You know, I'm all about penis enlargement over here. And yeah, like, oh, No Nut November's good. And like, I like to take a break from, it's like, my opinion, like, just G, as a G, like, I don't need, like, no fucking month that I'm gonna quit something. Like, that you're just a fucking sheep in a flock. Like, if you're gonna quit porn, just quit. You don't need to wait for November. I fucking smoke gas during October. I might quit weed in the middle of the summer. I'm not gonna do sober October and be a part of the fucking crowd. So when I say No Nut November's fucking stupid, it's dumb. Okay, you're addicted to porn. Black pill, accept it, stop watching porn. It's like if you bang a girl that you love, porn is so boring. I'll sit there for like an hour when my girl's like on a work trip or something. And I'll just be like, I have like triple monitors. Austin was editing. I'm like, I'll have like boom, boom, boom.
Every ounce of dopamine.
Yeah, I got my blue light glasses on. I'm just like literally going at it. I have XB1000s. Throw up the XB1000s. I have XB1000s, which are pro gaming headphones. And it's literally not even close to having intimate sex. So the whole point of No Nut November is not to just stop masturbating and watching porn for November. It's to fucking go on a date, pull a real girl, and have some real dopamine. So that's why I think No Nut November is dumb. I got attacked for just saying No Nut November is stupid, Austin. It's like, what do you think about
it? I feel like people twist it for like the whole like semen retention kick that everyone's on too.
Okay, what do you think about semen retention?
I think that's ridiculous, to be honest.
Yeah, and the thing about semen retention is like, so the next, if you don't, I'm never going to touch myself again. So the next time you go on a date, you're intimate, you're going to last like 5 seconds because you haven't been touching yourself. That might not score you the next altercation with the girl. With the girl, you're always competing against other dudes. Always. If you start lacking, a good girl will take it for a long time, but eventually she'll have her eyes open, right? So if you're not touching yourself for semen retention, I just don't get it. Like, I get natural testosterone, but like, you can beat your dick every once in a while. I don't think masturbate. Think how fucked the world would be if you couldn't masturbate and you had to get it from a female. That'd be insane. So I think masturbation in, you know, a normal amount when you're not like, I'm on my 8th hour of watching hentai. Like, if you're not doing that shit, you can beat your dick every once in a while. It's about authentic energy between an actual woman and you. So if you're doing No Nut November and then you just like, after November's over, you're like, all right. You're like, you have
up for lost time.
Literally, you have like your new lubes. You're like, all right, so taking my break. You know, it's just like, that's what I think. If you need to fucking have a month. I asked my girl what she thought and she just started fucking laughing, you know. And semen retention's stupid. Like, I have sex every day. I'm not saying you have to have sex every day, but, like, if I had the opportunity to have sex during November, I'm like, no, I'm not nutted. I'm retaining semen. Like, why would you not bang that girl?
That's the part where people get it twisted.
Yeah, why would you not go bang that girl? If a girl wants to get you off, let that energy happen. Oh, I'm retaining my semen. I'm gonna be real fucking figured up next week after November's over. I don't know. What do you guys think of No Nut November? I'm not making fun of porn addicts. I've had friends that are porn addicts and I've had, you know, I've been a computer programmer. Trust me. I've been around some extreme nerds. No hate. Black pill. They gotta wake up and smell the roses themselves. They don't need a fucking month where they can all be sheep together. Like, now Pornhub knows, like, all right, November, the numbers are gonna dip. And then after they're fiending, after they haven't nutted and watched our fucking shit, you know, next month we're gonna come out with something. Like, they already know their numbers. All porn knows that porn is gonna dip during November and then it's gonna go the next month. They already know that. There's enough OnlyFans models in the world that are sucking the Sims dry for No Nut November to make no fucking sense. No Nut November is supposed to make you go and have authentic dopamine exchange with another individual. So when I did that row thing and then came up and pulled, like, I was supposed to have failed on my knees.
Yeah.
So it's like a mental game.
You did good, sir.
It's that demented motherfucker. I'm kicking it with my brothers. I'm rapping a 5'9". You know, greater fucking color. My gas screaming killer. Wet them, hit them, wet it, left. Smoking like cemento, let the pistol up, it's right. Never could be fucked with, my dick ain't let her suck it. And call me getting 7-6, I switch up, it's like subjects. Full of continental, make a hunk of sentimental. Like an ATK dental, find me with no fundamentals. Michael Jackson off a thriller dose, holding for the killer dose. Cooking up in the rental, bam, ember with the killer toes. Gripping on my genitals, no aside genital. Pull up in the beans, once you turn the salt to cynical. Anyway, take a pop, die by any day.
Mask off when I'm back in the studio. Mac ain't make it to 27. Pox ain't make it to 26. Big ain't make it to
26. My eyeballs are just exploding. I'm like, keep going.
Yeah. But help us a motherfucking trap. Niggas envy when you famous first. They don't know what they name is worth. You just use my grammar. So my eyes feel filled with anna. This game like Home Depot, bitch.
Alright guys, I have to try the creamy root beer flavor of the new Zevia. I normally am only a cream soda Zevia guy, but this is... After one ASMR sip, you know it's a W. Cream soda hits. The cherry cola, mid. This is right up there. The regular root beer, which is the brown, it's kind of mid, honestly. Cream soda is absolutely, if you drink this ice cold, definitely helps the craving. Then I got some protein water. I like drinking whey protein water after, so I'm gonna drink two of these, which is, yeah, just whey protein isolate. So this hits like instantly. But yeah, that's the workout, right? You know, I told Austin it's gonna be really boring to film, but you need to crank the volume way up. All you saw was a ton of volume, fluff work. I'm gonna do every once in a while some more compound movement variants, but like, I have to train like a bodybuilder if I wanna be a bodybuilder. There's a reason why when you watch those IFBB pros, they train like that. I have to get my body accustomed to doing that much volume, and then maybe I can do some strength and density work. But if you guys want it all recorded, then we're gonna do it for you guys. And especially when I get with the coach and then he gives me my workout, I will follow right along. There's two ways you can train as a bodybuilder, and I've done both ways. So there's low volume training like Dorian Yates. When you low volume train, it's like a pyramid. So you build up to one set where you go stupid fucking deep into failure, which you saw me do on those back row sets. I just try to go so far into failure and pump the shit out of my body, and then you're exhausted after. And then there's high volume training, which I did towards the end and in the beginning. So I did both styles. They say for an ectomorph in parentheses like me, you should train more like Dorian. So I'll vary both styles. I know Regan Grimes trained super high volume and trained high volume for a long time to where his body got used to it. I'm not comparing myself genetically to a super freak. I just think that he could have benefited from not training every day, doing it more like 3 days a week in the gym. And then when I hear his interviews, he said no, he trained 6 days a week, super high volume, and he got used to it. And now, in my opinion, Regan has one of the best open physiques ever. So I'm leaning more towards high volume, right? Just based on, again, what the elite of the elite are doing. I will train Dorian style every once in a while, which that would be way more fun for Austin to record, because I have to get psyched up for like, you know, three big sets, right? And capturing that energy would be sick for the workout videos. But in the meantime, bodybuilding is a really boring ass sport. Have to do everything on point, and I'm just getting my body accustomed to training like this. I'm gonna get in contact with the coach. You guys are gonna be happy. I see you guys in the comment section. Even Austin sees you guys in the comment section on the coach you want, but I'm gonna speak to him in private and then we'll go from there. I'm not gonna announce anything until it's actually in motion. I'll see you guys in my next video, and stay ASMR sipping.